The Senate's passage of the proposed 4.5 trillion peso national budget for 2021 on Thursday was a quick one. Days before Thursday's period of amendments, Finance Committee Chairman Senator Sonny Angara had asked his colleagues to submit their individual budget amendments as to which government agencies will get budget cuts or require additional funds. In the Senate's approved measure, additional budget was given to social amelioration programs to help crisis-affected sectors. The 8 billion peso budget for anti-COVID-19 vaccines will get another 75 billion peso allocation for the procurement and distribution of vaccines. There's also money for contact tracing and hiring of additional health workers. For 2021, the education sector will receive the biggest increase, amounting to 712.35 billion pesos due to teaching and learning mode adjustments brought by COVID-19. Meantime, additional funds were also given to improve hospital facilities, address disaster-related concerns, and assist local government units, villages, and the agriculture sector. There are also budget increases for the repair of storm-damaged ports and airports, free Wi-Fi in state universities and colleges and public places, as well as the National Broadband Plan.
The amendments we propose demonstrate that we are doubling down in our commitment to respond more effectively to the pandemic, on our motivation to help more of our people struck by calamity, and our single-minded focus on restarting the economy.
Funds were also allocated to support Filipino athletes and the creation of a Philippine Judicial Martial Service to secure members of the judiciary.
Hopefully, inside the line items of this budget, our people see that indeed there is a path out of this pandemic and recession and that we are not without hope.
11 senators will sit at the Budget Bicameral Conference Committee meeting, which will start on Saturday. In the meantime, House Speaker Lord Alan Velasco has stopped 21 congressmen to represent the lower house in the bicameral meeting. Velasco assures the public there will be enough funds to buy vaccines for the initial government target of 20 million doses. The Senate and the House are targeting to hand over the ratified budget bill to the President before the year ends. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.